Good morning, dear students. A very hearty welcome to my channel and also welcome to your revision session. So this whole month we are going to revise the various topics which are already covered in the previous chapters, and we are also going to solve certain questions. So I'll be basically taking up grammar for you all. So I'll try my level best to tell you what are the various rules which are to be followed when you are working with different parts of speech, and also I am going to solve certain questions along with those explanations. Now already I had uploaded the full explanation videos in the month of April, so for that kindly visit my channel and watch all the videos for all the concepts. So all concepts have already been taught. In these sessions we are only going to solve exercises and just recapitulate all those past sessions. So let us start with today's class. So we are going to begin with pronouns. Today we are going to start pronouns. Now what are pronouns? A word that can be used in place of a noun is known as a pronoun. Anything used in place of a noun. Example, Hari is absent because Hari is ill. So here Hari can be replaced with he. Hari is absent because he is ill. Some pronouns we can mark over here. I am young. I is a pronoun. You are young. She is elder to both of us. He is a doctor. We are students of Parkland High School. So these words which are used in place of a noun, they are known as what? Pronouns. Now we are going to first start with personal pronouns. So all the words which you can see over here, I, we, you, he, she, it, they all are known as personal pronouns. They stand for three persons. The person speaking, that is the first person. The person being spoken to, that is the second person. And the person spoken of, that is your third person. So the first pronoun of the first person, second person and third person. So what is the pronoun of the first person? It denotes the person or persons speaking. Okay. The pronouns used are I and we. Second person denotes the person being spoken to. That is, if two people are talking, one is the person who is talking, other one is the person who is listening. So the one who is talking, that person is first person. The person to whom the talking is being done to, that is the person who is listening, is the second person. So the second person will be referred by you, and you is used in both singular as well as plural. And third person, it is used to denote person spoken of. They, he, she, it and so on. And there are three cases of personal pronouns, three forms of personal pronouns: nominative case, possessive case and accusative case. Now, what is the nominative case? In the nominative case, it is used for a noun or pronoun which is the subject of a verb. So, the pronoun is used as the subject of the verb. For example, Mark eats cakes. So, here Mark is what? Mark is a noun, right? Whereas if I have he eats cakes, so he will be the pronoun. And it is a nominative case. That is, simply this pronoun precedes your verb, right? So we are just referring to this pronoun as being the subject of this sentence, subject of the verb. They eat cakes. So they is again a pronoun which is being used in the nominative case. Second is possessive case. Now the word possessive itself comes from the word possession. Students, I'll be explaining few things to you. So I'll open the whiteboard. So possessive case itself, the name itself says that we are going to talk about possession. That is about owning something, right? So the possessive case is used for showing possession, that is ownership. The possessive case applies to nouns, pronouns, and determiners. So possessive case applies to these things: nouns, pronouns, and determiners. Nouns, name of a person, place, animal, thing, etc. Pronouns we have already seen, and determiners. So possessive nouns are nouns which are preceded by of, that is of Ramesh, of Carla, understood? And we can also say Ramesh's or Carla's. So these are what this is to represent possession, that is belongingness. Okay, a particular item or an action belongs to a noun. Next is, sorry, possessive pronouns. So you can see the possessive pronouns here: mine, yours, his, hers, its, ours, theirs. Possessive determiners: my, your, his, her, their, our, its, and they also fall under the category of adjectives. We know that adjectives are words which qualify a noun or a pronoun. So possessive adjectives. So possessive determiners are what? They are also possessive adjectives. Now next is accusative case. So here the main function is to show the object of a verb. What is the object? You can find the direct object by finding the verb and asking the question what or whom. Like the dog ate our turkey. So you can ask, the dog ate what? Or what did the dog eat? What did the dog eat? So we can simply ask this question. So answer will be our turkey. So turkey is what? It is the object of the verb. Which, what is the verb here? Ate. So dog ate our turkey. Understood? The leopard chased him for an hour. Chased him. Chased what? Chased him. Now let us see the three cases using in case of singular and plural. Nominative case, it is I or we. I love to dance. We went sightseeing. Okay, when it comes to possessive, mine, this is my dog, or this dog is mine. Okay, so that becomes possessive. Our, this is our house, that house is ours, that house is ours. Accusative, he gave me a letter. So here I am saying, he gave me a letter. So he gave something to me. He gave me a letter. So here me is what? It is the object, or we can say it is the direct object. Letter is the indirect object. So he gave me a letter. So here me is being used in which case? It's used in the accusative case. Us, the committee banned us from the concert. So us, banned who? Banned whom? Banned us. So us is the direct object, right? So the committee banned us. So us is being used in which form? In the accusative form. Second person, nominative case, you. So we will say, you ate the whole dish. So you, simple, that is nominative case. Yours, this is your book. So here your works as a possessive adjective, because it qualifies this noun book. Okay, then we say this book is yours. So now this yours is being used as a possessive pronoun. You. This book was owned by you. So owned by you, right? Or I can say he gave you a letter. He gave you a letter. So he gave what? He gave whom a letter? He gave you a letter. So you ask a question, what or whom? If it is a person, you should ask the question whom. So here you is being used in which case? It's used in the accusative case. Next is the third person. Nominative case, he, she, it. He eats cakes, she eats cakes, it. It, you can say, it rolls down the stairs, right? It could be anything. It could be any object. It could be any animal or anything, right? They eat cakes, right? So this is the nominative case. When we say possessive, his book, her book, right? So here it can be used as what? His book, her book. This is being used as a possessive adjective. But when I say this book is hers, this book is his. So I'm writing it like this. This book is hers. So here this hers is in the, it is what? It is the possessive pronoun. This book is her. That is, it directly follows the verb. Is the auxiliary verb. So it immediately follows the auxiliary verb. The robot used its arm to cook an omelette. Today in the morning itself, I saw a video where a robotic arm was cooking an omelette somewhere in a mall, in a shopping mall at Singapore. So I just saw that. So the robot used its arm. So its arm, whose arm? Its arm. So it is used as a possessive adjective, right? And we can also say this arm is its. Although this doesn't sound very good, but it is still, if you want to use it in the possessive case, it would be this one. There. This is their house. This house is theirs. Right. Then next is accusative case. So him, her, it. So we say, I gave him a letter. She gave her a letter. Okay. He brought it to his house. Then I gave them some tea, or I served them some tea. So this is what being used in the accusative case. Some possessive adjectives I have already explained, like my, our, your, her, their. This is my notebook. So this is my notebook. Those are your books. That is her computer. So this, or your, her, my, these all are possessive adjectives. Possessive pronouns. The word his is used both as adjective as well as a pronoun. This is his car. This car is his. So right now, what is it doing? Here it is directly modifying the noun, and here it is immediately following the verb. Some sentences. This book is mine. Those books are yours. That book is hers. That idea of yours is excellent. These all are examples of possessive pronouns. Now the pronoun it, there are some rules which we need to follow for pronoun it. So what are they? Where is it used? First, for things without life. For example, for things without life, like I can say, I brought a table fan yesterday. It barely works. So I am referring to what? I am referring to the object that is table fan. Okay, so I brought a table fan. Table fan is the object and it is also the noun. So this it refers to this table fan. Next is for animals. I can say the dog was hit by a car. It was whimpering with agony. That is great pain. So it, I am referring to the dog over here, right? Until and unless it's my pet dog. Sometimes we tend to have a pet dog and we tend to refer to it using its gender. Like Rocky is a handsome boy, or I can say Rocky is my dog. He is a handsome guy. So I am personalizing Rocky over here, because normally we tend to be very close to our pets. So sometimes, and so we tend to consider them as our family members. So at that case, I can make use of this pronoun he. But usually what is used? It is used to represent animals. Okay. Next is for a young child. So I can say the child was crying. It was hungry. Or we can say the baby was crying. It was uncomfortable. So here it refers to child and here it refers to baby, until and unless you are trying to refer to its gender. Next is to refer to some statement going before. Example is Ravi had done something wrong and he knew it. So what did he know? That he had done something wrong. So this is the statement. So it says to refer to some statement going before. This is the statement. Okay. And this it is referring to this statement. As a provisional and temporary subject before verb to be when the real subject follows. Right? It is a good programming practice to use comment lines. So normally we would say it like this. to use comment lines is a good programming practice. Okay, we would say it this way. To use comment lines is a good programming practice. So we would say it this way. So as a provisional and temporary subject. So here it refers to a temporary subject before the verb to be when the real object follows, real subject follows. Now what would be the real subject? Good programming practice. It is, we can say good programming practice over here. So a good programming practice, this would be the subject of your verb. So in usually if we write it this way, here this subject falls after the verb. Understood? But we are using it to represent that. So it is a good programming practice to use comment lines. So it is used as a provisional and temporary subject. Next is to give emphasis to the noun or pronoun following. To give emphasis to the noun or pronoun following. Now what does this mean? So here it would be, it was she who started the chaos. So it was she. So over here I am referring to this as to give emphasis to the noun or pronoun following. So I am giving an emphasis to the noun or pronoun following. So here it was she. So I am giving emphasis to what? It was who? It was she who started the chaos. So I am specifically laying emphasis on this. It was I who did the work. It was she who did the work. Understood? It was he who brought the food. Next is, as an indefinite nominative of an impersonal verb, like it rains, it snows. So here rains is what? It is an impersonal verb. When I say impersonal verb, it means it doesn't refer to any particular person. It rains. Okay, so it's an impersonal verb and hence it refers to that. Next is, in speaking of the weather or time, it is winter here in Canada. So it is winter. So we are referring to a particular season or weather, right? Weather or a season, or it is very cold outside. So it refers to the weather outside, right? Or time, it is 9 o'clock. So it is 9 o'clock. So we are referring to time over here. Personal pronoun should be of same number, gender and person as that of the noun for which it stands. Like Hari is a good boy. He always excels in class. So Hari is a good boy. You can see what is the gender. Gender is masculine gender. What is the person? It is the third person. Right. And what is it? Whether it is singular or plural, it is singular. Hence, the pronoun which follows should also follow this. It should also be singular. It should also be masculine gender and it should also be in the third person. Okay. Some rules. When a pronoun stands for a collective noun, it must be in the singular number and neuter gender if the collective noun is viewed as a whole. So let us check this out. So we can say, The army was running out of its monthly rations. So you can see it is in the neuter gender also, and it is basically referring. It's basically singular, because here I am using a collective noun army, which is a collection of soldiers. Okay, so but those that collection of soldiers is being referred to as a whole, that is as an army. So the army was running out of its monthly rations. Next is, if the collective noun conveys the idea of separate individuals comprising the whole, the pronoun standing for it must be plural. That is, I write, the committee didn't leave their seats till they arrived at a consensus. So here committee is a collective noun, that's fine, but I am referring to seats. They didn't leave their seats, that is, we are referring to all the people who are within the committee, and hence this is what this is referring, and seats is what plural. That is why this pronoun should also be plural. When two or more singular nouns are joined by and, the pronoun used for them must be plural. Like, so we'll just repeat it once again. When two or more singular nouns are joined by and, the pronoun used for them must be plural. For example, we can say, Ram and Hari are best friends. They help each other in need. So here you can say Ram and Hari. These are two people, and this is also singular and this is also singular. But when I am referring to both of them, I am saying Ram and Hari are best friends. Are best friends. They help each other, because these are what? They are two people. So here I will be using they, because I am using and to join them. When I say Ram and Hari, it means I am making 1 plus 1, 2. And when it is 2, it should be plural. Next, when two singular nouns joined by and refer to the same person or thing, the pronoun used must be singular. Let's see an example of this. So now here I am talking about one single person who is the president as well as a mother. So I am referring to this person who failed to do her duty. So here president and mother refer to the same person. So that's the reason why the pronoun which I will be using will be what? Singular. When two singular nouns joined by and are preceded by each and every, the pronoun must be singular. So let's see an example of this. Each student and each teacher was scared to go out of the campus. Or wait, I'll use another one. I'll reform this sentence. Each student and each teacher didn't leave his or her place. So you can see each student, each teacher. Now within each student or each teacher, we can have men as well as women, boys as well as girls. So didn't leave his or her place. So his or her. Every soldier and every sailor was stationed at his place, at his position. That is every soldier and every sailor. So I am using soldier, that is, it is a noun, sailor is a noun. Here also student is a noun, teacher is a noun. And before that I am using each and every determiner. Okay, was stationed at his position, because I am referring to an individual person over here. When two or more singular nouns are joined by or, we can say or, either or, neither nor, pronoun is also singular. Like, we'll see this. I say Ravi or Rehan should lend his hand. So I have used or in between, that is either Ravi will be chosen or Rehan will be chosen. So Ravi or Rehan, and you can also see that it is masculine gender and singular, so that's why lend his hand, because here I am referring to any one person out of these two. Either or, either Seema or Savita have lost her book. So Seema or Savita, you can say that both of their genders are what? Feminine genders, and they are singular. So lost her book. Had it been either Seema or Suresh, has lost his or her book, or her or his book. Because here, if it is Seema or Suresh, so one of them is feminine, one of them is masculine. So I will be referring it to it like this, her, his. Her will be referring to Seema and his will be referring to Suresh. Got it? Next, when a plural noun or singular noun are joined by or, nor, pronoun must be plural. So plural noun or singular noun, they are joined by or nor. That is, the guard or the group had left their spot. So here I am referring to, this is singular, whereas the group is what? It is your, group is also singular. I'll change the question. Amit or the members of the club were going to attend a party. So Amit is what? Amit is singular, whereas members is what? Members is plural. So here of the club were going to attend a party, or I can also change this because I need to show a pronoun over here. So Amit or the members of the club were going to attend their graduation ceremony, because here one is singular, one is plural. So when one is singular and the other is plural and joined by or nor, then the pronoun is going to be also plural. When a pronoun refers to more than one noun or pronoun of different persons, it must be of first person preference to the second. Okay. Second person preference to the third. So let us check the first one. So when a pronoun refers to more than one noun or pronoun of different persons, then how will we do it? So I write here, you and I have done our part. So it is what? Referring to the first person. We have second person, we have first person. So the pronoun will always be referring to the first person only. So you and I, and it will be plural in nature. You and I have done our part. That is, there are one plus one, two people. So that's why it is plural. And you and I have done our part. So preference will be to the first person. Similarly, next is second person preference to the third. You and Ravi have done your jobs well. So you is second person, Ravi is third person, and instead of Ravi, suppose we have he. You and he have done your jobs well. So here the preference will be to the second person only. So preference will be to the second person over here. Some good manners, you can see you and I, you and he, Hari and I. You should always keep a second person before the first person, right? Second person before the third person, and Hari, third person before the first person. Instead of I and you, he and you, I and Hari. So the correct usage are these. Personal pronouns versus accusative case. So some personal pronouns are I, he, she, we, they. So when I take the accusative case, so here the accusative case of I will be me. He gave me a letter. Okay. Or us. He gave us a letter. Right, so us is usually in the plural form. So me, then he, him, she, her, we, us, they, them. Okay, so this is it. Me, him, her, us, them. That is the accusative case. Right, so I can say, over here, he gave me a letter. I gave him some food. Okay. I visited her when she was staying with her grandmother. They gave us an offer. Okay. I gave them some water. So this is what accusative case. When I am directly referring to some object of the verb using a particular pronoun or a noun. So let us solve some questions related to it now. So I am going to solve some questions. So let's take a look at this page over here. So I am going to switch on my drawing tools over here, and let me take up some color. I am taking the blue color. So here we are. In the following sentences, point out the pronouns and say for what each stands. Alice was not a bit hurt and she jumped up onto her feet in a moment. So she, it refers to what? Alice jumped up on her feet to a moment, that is her also refers to what? Alice. So in the exam, if you have a question like this in the exam, you would be writing it in this way, that is she comma her both refer to Alice, right? So she and her are the pronouns which are being used and Alice refers to the subject. So Alice was not a bit hurt. So Alice is the subject, or Alice is the noun which is being referred in this sentence. There were doors all round the hall, but they were all locked. So they were all locked. So they refers to what? Doors. Alice opened the door and found that it led into a small passage. So found that it led. So it refers to some non-living thing. So what it refers to? Door. I wish I hadn't cried so much, said Alice. So I wish I it both of them refer to Alice. You are not attending, said the mouse to Alice severely. What are you thinking of? So you are not attending. You mouse is speaking to Alice. So that's why mouse is saying you. So you is being referred to Alice. What are you thinking of? So again you refers to Alice. Come back, the caterpillar called after her. Alice turned and came back again. So the caterpillar called after her. Her refers to Alice. Hari brought his book and laid it on the table. So Hari brought his book. His refers to what? Hari. And laid it on the table. So it is the pronoun which is referring to Hari's book. That is book. So here it would be Hari. His and book it. Got it? Karim has lost his dog and cannot find it. His, it. So his refers to what? Karim. Whereas it refers to dog. Suresh is at the head of his class for he studies hard. So Suresh is at the head of his class. His refers to Suresh. For he studies hard, so he also refers to Suresh. Rama, you are a lazy boy. So you refers to Rama. The camel is a beast of burden. It is used to carry goods across the desert. So it refers to camel. The female lion is called a lioness. She has no mane. So over here, she refers to what? The female lion. Or we can also say the lioness. Either female lion or lioness, both are correct. So you can write she refers to female lion or lioness. The horse fell down and broke its leg. So its leg, it refers to horse. Birds build their nests in trees. So their refers to birds. If the thief is caught, he will be punished. He refers to the thief. Train up a child in the way he should go. So he refers to child. And Nathan said to David, thou art the man. So though, Nathan is talking to David. So when he is using though is an archaic form of you. That is an outdated or obsolete form of you. In very old English, you was basically referred to, though was basically used to refer to you, and art was used to refer to A-R-E-R, right? In archaic form of you. So though is referring to what? David. Next, in the following sentences, use pronouns in place of nouns wherever you can. Rama had taken his watch out of his pocket and was looking at the watch uneasily. So I can replace this watch by looking at it uneasily, because Rama had taken his watch out of his pocket. So already I have mentioned the noun here, and was looking at it uneasily, shaking the watch every now and then and holding the watch to his ears. So shaking it every now and then and holding it to his ear. The boys went into the garden where the boys saw a snake. The boys went into the garden where they saw a snake. Snake is being referred for the first time, so we are not going to use it over here. Okay, here you can use pronoun only when it is referring to some noun. So here already they is referring to boys. Very soon the rabbit noticed Alice as Alice went hunting about. So instead of as Alice, as she went hunting about, and called out to her in an angry tone. So here it is being used in the accusative case. She went hunting about being used in the nominative case. Write the correct form of pronoun in the following. We scored as many goals as them. Rama and Dash were present. Rama and I were present. It was Dash that gave you the alarm. It was me that gave you the alarm. So, okay. Next is between you and I don't believe him. In the seventh question, it was me that gave you the alarm. It was I that gave you the alarm. So both I and me are correct in this sentence. Between you and me, I do not believe him. We are not so poor as them. Rama is as old as me. He is known to my brother and me. He is as good as me. Nobody but he was present. Or we can also say nobody but him was present. So let's check the answer from the answer keys. The 13th one is him. Nobody but him was present. But I personally feel that nobody but he was present is also correct. He and I were great friends. So let's check question number 14. Yes, it is correct. He and I were great friends. Whom can I trust if not him? Let him who can answer this question. Let him who can answer this question. So there's a pause after can. It's just a short for let him who can answer this question. So instead of using answer twice, they have used it once. There isn't much difference between you and him. None so blind as they that will not see. So let's check 18th question. It is they. None so blind as they. Blind as they that will not see. It isn't for such as them to dictate us. So students, that's all in today's class. I hope you all have understood today's class, and this is just a small revision session for you all. Already I have uploaded the video some time ago. I had uploaded the video in the month of April. So, and I had uploaded it for every topic of grammar. So please watch those videos and you'll get a revision of all the topics which we have already covered. And in this revision session, we are going to exclusively solve exercises. And please use the book High School English Grammar by Renan Martin, because I'm also referring to that. It's a very good book for referring to English grammar. So please use this book whenever you are solving questions. So thank you everybody, and see you again in the next class.